thank him, amen. Thank the Lord, amen, amen, amen. Not going, amen.
Yes, okay.
Be before you very long today. Hopefully, amen. Amen. Know y'all got them pots on your mind. Amen, amen, amen. Just want to talk to you a little bit out of this scripture reading. Amen. Out of the book of Matthew. Amen. Matthew, amen. But some in Matthew 13:8 it says, but others fell in good ground, amen, and brought forth some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30, amen. We thank God, amen. We give God praise, glory, and honor, amen. He said, I like the way it says, some fell in good ground, amen. You know, we gardening, trying to get an increase from the ground or something, amen. You got to find some good ground, amen. You can't go around sowing your seeds in sand, amen. And you're not going to get nothing if you don't put nothing in, amen. Unless you're in the steel. Hello, somebody, amen. You really ain't going to get nothing there. Worth nothing, amen. Amen, amen, but a bunch of trouble, amen. Amen, especially if the man don't catch it, if whoever feel that he is catching. Amen. That's what we end up at. Amen. Hello, somebody. Sometimes we rather for the man to get a hold to. We don't like the man. But sometimes we be glad to see the man. Amen. Sometimes we be the one out of you the man, you the man. Hello, somebody. Amen. I thank God. Amen. That he is the man. Amen. 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 Some fell on good ground, amen. And I like this ninth verse that says, who has an ear to hear, let him hear, amen. What that let me know is that everybody, y'all don't want to talk to me, amen. Everybody ain't trying to hear, amen. Everybody ain't trying to hear, amen. The Bible says all men don't have the faith. Amen. See, we supposed to be the light of the world, but I think many of us don't understand the word. Amen. We don't really have the word in the way we're supposed to have it. You know, I read in that book. Amen. Look, going back there, I read in the book of Ephesians. Amen. That in that fourth chapter, amen. I like reading where it says, hello somebody, amen. In the 23rd verse, and he and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, amen. And a lot of us, you know, a lot of times, if we don't pay close attention, we miss what he's talking about, amen. Hello somebody. Because in the book of James, it says, a double-minded man we'll receive nothing of the Lord, amen. And when we begin to talk about double-mindedness, we don't really comprehend or understand, amen, what God is sharing with us, amen. Amen. He began, and basically because we don't have any understanding. Amen. Amen. So when he said a double-minded man, see, you can be double-minded. Hello, somebody. Look, I tell you what. Let's do this. Let's go to 2 Corinthians. No, 1 Corinthians, the second chapter. Amen. Amen. And where it says in the 11th verse, it says in the 10th verse, 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, 10th verse, said, but God has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. Amen. Well, y'all ain't trying to get to there. That's all right. All right. All right. All right. Keep your hand right there and go with me. Just walk with me for a minute. We're going to walk through a few scriptures when we get an understanding. Amen. Revelation, the second chapter. Yeah, that's supposed to scare y'all. Y'all, hello, somebody. Revelation, the second chapter. And I want to share with you that seventh verse. It says, he that has an ear, let him hear. Huh? Oh, y'all ain't got that yet, man. Maybe y'all ain't got all your glasses or something. Amen. He that has an ear, let him hear. Hello, somebody. Amen. What the Spirit has to say unto the churches. Now, who is the church? You and I. We are the churches. Amen. We are the churches that we're talking about. It says so. What did he say? He said, "He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has said unto the church. To him that overcome will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst, of the paradise of God." Now we're not talking about, amen, down here on earth. See, we're looking for the God to eat down here. But everything is vain under the sun. Hello, somebody, amen. And it says, he that has an ear, wait a minute, y'all got that right. He that has an ear, let him hear what the what? The Spirit has the what? Oh, y'all don't need to jump off now. Look, I'm gonna jump y'all off. I'm gonna read the whole thing and then maybe y'all will catch up. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say to the churches. You have to say churches. You, hello, somebody. Amen. Are we there? Are we there? He that has an ear, let him hear what?
What the Spirit says to the
church. Somebody else still kind of dragging. Everything all right? All right. Hello, somebody. All right. So I thank the Lord. Amen. I give God praise, glory, and honor. Amen. What's it? Now go back to that first Corinthians, second chapter. Because we want to know. We want to understand. How many of y'all want the increase? How many of y'all want to flow in the blessing? How many of y'all want to understand? I ain't talking about. See, we're going to talk about what kind of blessing now. Amen. Because some of y'all are with the clap of your hand because you think you better get a few dollars. I'm just saying. Amen. Hello, somebody. I'm just saying. Amen. Look what he said now. In 1 Corinthians, the second chapter in the 10th verse, it says, but God has revealed them unto us by what? By what? For the Spirit searches all things. Hello, somebody, huh? Yet the deep things of God. Amen. Now listen to this here. For what man knoweth the things of man, say the spirit of man which is in him. Even so, the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Amen. So in other words, in order for you to understand what God is talking about, you got to be born again. See, when you double-minded, you got the mind of a spirit of God, and you got the mind of a man, a worthy man, amen? You got that sensual mind, that devilish mind. That's why some of us can't get past from the fornication and the mess up some of our lives, because we got that worldly spirit. And we hello somebody, and we try to listen to both of them at the same time. We try to listen, do you love dealing, shake your booty, and shake y'all don't want to talk to me. I'm just saying, amen, you that's what it is. Now, I'm just, I don't know the song, but and I ain't trying to learn it, but hello somebody, amen. And forgetting those things that are behind, amen, I thank the Lord. So when he says that, he didn't have the ear, let him hear what the Spirit, he's talking about the Spirit of God has to send to the churches, amen. So when it began to talk about the paradise of God, it's talking about another Eve. When it's talking about the God of Eve, it ain't talking about from a man's perspective, because the wisdom of God is higher than the wisdom of man. See, the wisdom of this world is foolishness in our sight of God. You go out and searching the whole earth, looking at the maps and everything, and God's looking at you like, what's wrong with them people down there? You know somebody, amen. I'm telling them about something sacred. I'm telling them about something holy. I'm telling them about something that hell somebody, a place where they are somebody. See, what you got to understand is when man was created, amen, the Bible said Adam was the son of God. In other words, man created in the image of God. Now, if you don't have the Spirit of God, you're none of his. In other words, you're not, hello somebody. See, Adam started having children after himself. Y'all don't want to talk to me. So everybody don't have the Spirit of God, amen? So when he say you got to be renewed in the spirit of your mind, he's saying that man or that woman spirit that you have, you got to replace it with a God spirit. Tell somebody, well, you're not going to get this, amen? And if you don't get this, you're not going to be, it's not going to profit you. Tell somebody, amen? I'm just saying, amen? Look what he said. Look what he said in Hebrews. In Hebrews chapter 4. Hello, somebody. I'm just saying, amen. Look what he said in Hebrews chapter 4 and the very second verse. I read the first. It said, let us therefore fear lest a promise being left for us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached. That's that word sown. See, the sower went out to sow. So he went out to preach the word. He went out to give the word. He went out to sow the word. Amen. He said, for unto us was the gospel preached of the seed sown as well as unto them. Amen. But we know some of them, it fell by the wayside. It fell amongst thorny ground. It fell among thorns and thickets, amen. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody, amen. And some of that stuff got up and choked it. You, when you choke somebody, choke something, you restrict the air. Hello, somebody. And it does not go, hello, somebody. It does not flow like it's supposed to flow. It does not go like it's supposed to. Hello, somebody. I thank the Lord, amen. I give God praise, glory, and honor, amen. It does not flow like that, amen. So when you begin to choke some vegetation, when you begin to choke the word of God, amen, it does not give out. It restricts how it gives out. It's not breathing in a proper manner, amen. It's not giving out the percentage that is necessary, hello somebody, to sustain the life in it. Hello somebody, amen. So you're not getting the full crop. You're not getting, you don't have anything to encourage yourself. To encourage yourself, amen. Acting like, you know, we being blessed around here. Some of y'all getting houses, some of y'all getting cars, or some of y'all getting cars, you're on your way to get houses, amen. But you can let the thing, you can let the thing, you can let that man, that worldly mind show your spiritual blessing. Hell somebody. Amen. You know what I mean? See, the Bible said, give a prophet, a righteous man, a disciple, a cold glass of water. See, a glass of water is something to quench the thirst. Amen. The Bible said, bless the man of God, you shall be blessed. See, we building a house of God here. We building a house of God. And we are fishing in this neighborhood because we'll make it rain. So when you leave the parking lot out there empty because you got some other thing, you're not blessing the man of God. You cursing the man of God. And when you curse the man of God, God goes, y'all don't want to talk to me. See, God is not mobbed. You're going to reap what you sow. I don't care who you are. You're going to reap because we got purpose in us. There's purpose here. Y'all, wait, let me cave somewhere, because we get the hell out of here. I want to cave somewhere real quick. Huh? We'll come back here. But I want to cave right here. The Genesis chapter 26. Genesis 26 and 12. I want to read a little short scripture there. It ain't going to take long, amen? I want to read a little short scripture that said, we'll stay here for a minute. It said, then Genesis 26 and 12 to y'all Bible study. Now the rest of y'all might have slowed down. Wait a minute here. Hello somebody. Somebody's gonna be going too fast. Now I got to get this up because I got to eat tomorrow. Hello somebody, get your notepads. I get this up. You shorthand writing or something, amen. Hello somebody, amen. You know how that scribble you been doing. You know how to come back to it, amen. Look what he said, Genesis 26 and 12. Then Isaac sold in the land, oh, y'all don't want to talk to me, and received the same year 100-fold, huh? The Lord blessed him, amen? Oh, y'all don't want to talk to me. See, you got to understand verse 2 to understand 12. Let me read verse 2, because this is in the famine. Now, it's been a famine. See, in verse 1, he said, and there was a famine in the land beside the first famine that was in the day of Abraham. Amen. And Isaac went up to Abimelech, the Philistines. Look at verse 2. It said, and the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not, see, don't go where you're going. Don't go back in Egypt land. Don't go and get all messed up now. Go where I send you, amen. See, you got a mind of a man and a mind of God. I'm telling you where to go at. I'm telling you where the water is. I'm telling you where the blessing is. You want to run out there, y'all don't want to talk to me. You got to have the renewing of the spirit of your mind. Your mind got to be connected with God. You can't have no lights in your house and you disconnected. They'll tuck the meat off. You can't go red. Come on, God. Oh, somebody, I'm just saying, amen. If you got to hearken unto God, you got to hear God. You know, I ain't going to that old place down there. I'm going where God told me to go in. I don't fool with them people. I'm going where God told me to go in. Look at everything I said cross-pollinated. I'm not against all kind of people. You know what I'm saying? If every man in the world want to turn to a woman, I ain't mad. I'm not mad. Yeah, I'm not going to try to tell you you got to be a man. I'm not going to push that in your head. That's crazy. Somebody might look out for these women. If it's have to be me, I just have to make that sacrifice. Not all of them one time. Y'all come see me. One of y'all get it 6 o'clock. 7. I'm just saying, amen. I'm going to see it in a perspective where it's blessing me. Hello, somebody. Somebody got to look out for me. Somebody got to look out for me. Hello, somebody. Amen. I thank the Lord. I give God praise, glory, and honor. God is blessing me. Amen. This is all about God. This is about my blessing. Amen. This is about, hello, somebody. So he said, look what he said in verse 2. He said, the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down unto Egypt, dwell in the land which I tell thee of. Sojourn in the land, and I will be with you and will bless thee. How many of y'all want God to be with you? He said, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit. See, that goes back to the book of James. A double-minded man will receive nothing of the Lord. He is in disobedience to the word of God. He is disobedient. Hello, somebody. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Disobedience is the spirit of witchcraft. You're dealing with a system of a devilish spirit. Hello, somebody. Amen. When you're not, what Bible said, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit has to say unto the church. And the church, Jesus Christ is the head of the church. Jesus Christ is our head, amen? Yeah. Hello, somebody, amen? He said, other flocks I have that I got to bring in, but he ain't trying to be the head of everybody. God said, be ye holy, for I'm holy. He told me to be popular. I ain't been to run behind you or love me. You can win the whole world, lose your own soul. Hello, somebody, amen. What God has for me is for me. It ain't for you, you, and you. It's for me. Hello, somebody. The Bible says, bless the man of God, you shall be blessed. Amen. We're working to build up a body of Christ here. Hello, about if God is blessing you, he's not blessing you for something to go give to somebody else. He's blessing you for right here. Yes. This is where he's going to bless you at. And if you got a problem with that, he just won't bless you. Well, I tell you what. When I was a young man. Man, I remember sitting over there on Mary on the back step. Oh, not on Mary, on Hope. On the back step. I'm glad when I get grown, I'm getting up out of here. I remember spelling that check. Huh? Coming through the door. Hello, somebody, amen. And all of a sudden, I ain't want to be grown no more. I want to eat. See, God knows you got to eat. So you can get high up on your horse all you want to. There are people that be in the church and leave. I ain't thinking about that old man. That's right. Live well a little bit more. Right. You know that one? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. See, now there's two minds. There's a spiritual mind, there's a carnal mind. The Bible says, whatever you sow, you're going to reap. Some people, if you reap to the cardinal mind, or say, man, you're going to die. If you reap to God, you're going to live. Hello, somebody. Yeah. So you ain't got to hear. Some people, you know, whatever you sow, you know, a lot of people, that's like people get up in the morning, they running to get to work, but they take their time to get to church. So they sowing to the world. They sowing to the cardinal mind. That's why the Bible said, hello somebody, 1 Corinthians 2, hello somebody, said that 2 and 10 and 11, said the things that are discerned by the things of God are discerned by the Spirit of God, but the things of man are discerned by the Spirit of man. So that one, you got two minds there. So a double-minded man is somebody that has a cardinal mind and try to work it with a spiritual mind. He try to have both of them. Amen. See, I was raised to do things deep in order. If I want Reggie Brown to do something for me, I'm going to call him in advance. I ain't going to call him. Look up. If I'm going to call the job, I ain't going to be there. If I'm going to call the contractor, if I'm setting up my work all week long for the world, and when it comes to God, I can call you whenever I get ready. God is offended with me. Y'all don't want to talk to me because the Bible said in the book of Malachi, do not bring spotted ram or you're going to jump before God. You have a double mind. You are trying to play fake God and live worldly. You trying to get a hold to a dollar instead of the Spirit of God. You will call everybody for a dollar, but if you got to call on the name of Jesus, you're about lost. I'm just saying. That's what the word is. Hello, somebody. So he said, Isaac sold in that land where God put him at. Yeah, y'all know. Let me go back to 2, verse 2. It said, and the Lord, at verse 3, it said, and sojourn in the land. No, verse 2. It said, the Lord appeared unto him and said, go not down unto Egypt where y'all run to. Where that worldly mind came. Where you think safe is. Where you think salvation is. Where you think you're going to eat it. Where you think you're going to get on it. Huh? But be renewed by the spirit of your mind. Don't follow that word of the spirit. Don't follow that spirit of a man. Follow every word that proceeded. Hello, somebody. Huh? See, man said, I live by bread. Hello, somebody. But by every word, amen. See, in other words, Jesus said it like this here. I am the door. Hello, somebody. And if you don't come up through the door, you come up some other way. And the other way is not the way to the paradise. The other way is not the way to live. The other way is the way of the tear. See that tear in that wheat? A lot of people, that tear, we didn't leave a home. Your brother, the Bible said, Jesus said, I come. In other words, the word come. You said, Father at barriers with the Son. And the Son of Mary, hell, somebody, I come to separate the wheat from the tare. I come to separate the child of God that has the Spirit of God from the child that has the word in mind. I come in your home, in your house, in your mama. See, mama never have a word in mind. I don't care about them going to church. They go to church and be creepy, but I'm talking about saints of God. Y'all don't want to. Tell somebody. See, you can go and train and sit on the pew all you want to, but if there is no conversion, the Bible said it had ears to hear, but did not, could not hear, did eyes to see, but could not hear, could not see. Tell somebody, if they could see, because they could see from a cardinal perspective, but they didn't have no spiritual eye. They could see right in front of them, but they couldn't see it for all. Tell somebody. Hello, somebody. If you don't look at your house, you can tell spirit from the flesh. The flesh will put gas in a container, the spirit will not. It will not do it. It won't do it because the spirit is life and it sees the fall. It's the spirit of the seer. And he can see past all that. That cardinal mind and card is just cardinal. It has nothing to do with God. Hello, somebody. You know what God is blessed me? God makes you do tithes and offerings, but that's all. And a lot of times that's to facilitate the things of God. It ain't got nothing to do with you. You ain't growing in, but then you ain't developing. Because you sow cardinal, you're going to reap whatever you sow. I don't care where you go. Hello, somebody. If you sow unto the flesh, you're going to sow unto death. In other words, you're not going to see very far. You're going to be ignorant or stupid, whatever. You ain't going to have knowledge or nothing. Hello, somebody. My people perish or are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. You're in the Bible said. I mean, boy, I need to finish both of you. This ain't good, y'all. Because, hello, somebody. I just tell you what, 2 Corinthians, if you keep reading it, it says not only does it discern the spirit discern, but it lets us know everything that's freely given unto us, the spirit of God, which Jesus is the dough to both. Hello, somebody. You can't increase and make a profit in the hell of somebody other than the Spirit of God. You can have, see, terror don't give life. Huh? Terror is worse. I tell you what, I didn't want to leave him, but I got to go. Matthew 13. I want to show you something. See? Hello, somebody. In verse 24 of Matthew 13, it says, another parable put forth, the kingdom of God is unto a man that soweth good seed in his field. And why? Me except his enemy came and sold terror. Amen? Here's where I want to go. Matthew 13 and 37. He answered and said, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom. But the terror of the kingdom of the wickedness. Hello, somebody. Amen. See, God created man in his image. And man is created after Adam. He's not created in the image of God. He is the mind of Adam. But the fallen Adam, not the y'all don't want to talk to me. I'm going to play a game with y'all. Can I play a game with y'all? I'm on that simplicity stage. Lord, can I do this? Yeah? I'm on that simplicity stage. If simplicity stage, it'll be all right, right? Let me see if I get this. It might be there. What turns into a butterfly?
According to Scientific American, one day, a caterpillar stops eating, hangs upside down from a twig or leaf, and spins itself a silky cocoon or molds into a shiny chrysalis.
In order for a caterpillar to turn into a butterfly, he has to press all the fast. He has to stop eating. And he has to turn bottom sides up. He can't go by the things in his world. He got to become a fool in his world, become wise with God. And he got to spin this thing around him, or he got to have them angels of protection around. Y'all don't want to talk to me before he can even get his way. See, you want to do things awkward? That everything God put together and cross pollinates into the thing of God. This thing don't work but one way. See, the Bible says he that received the seed in good ground. In other words, he understood the word. He understood the word. And some brought forth 30-fold. See, you ain't gonna break forth over 100-fold. Now don't get me wrong. You ain't gonna go 200-fold. You ain't gonna see that in the Bible. Hello, somebody. You know what the 30-fold is? 30-fold is 30 times whatever you sow. If you sow a dollar, you're gonna get $30 back. If you throw a dollar, and if your understanding is more key, then you're gonna get $60 back. And if you throw a dollar with perfect understanding, you're gonna get $100. Hello, somebody, amen. If you don't ease your hand up out that line mouth and ain't double-minded and ain't trying to let that stuff hold you back and done with 100% God, if you don't forsake yourself and picking up the cross, and hello somebody, if you don't stop trying to save your life, if you don't stop trying to walk around and be folded and starve and have a worldly mind, if you don't, hello somebody, the Bible said be holy, for I am holy, amen. Cause I ain't never seen nobody walk around spoiled all that shawl, had nothing no more than clothes on their back. See, one thing about the blessing of this world, hello somebody, the blessing of this world, hello somebody, that tear, what you get from a worldly mind, you will have a check this week, and if it don't come next week, you'll be broke. Hello somebody, but Isaac got 100-fold in a famine, in the second famine. His dad had already wore out the first one. He was just like his dad. He got a hundredfold from going where God told. Wait a minute. You got to really read that what it said. Look at that. That third verse, it said, so sojourn in the land, and I will be with thee and will bless thee for unto thee and unto thy seed. Look at that. There you go. Unto thy seed will I give all these countries, and I will perform the oath which I swore unto Abraham thy father, and I will make thy seed multiply as the stars of heaven, and will give unto thy seed all the countries, and in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. Look at him. Because that Abraham, not with a double minded, but because Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandments, and my statutes, and my law. You ain't have to give no instruction to Abraham. The Bible says, when you feel with the Bible says, when you feel with the Spirit of God, that the Holy Ghost will lead and guide you. The Holy Ghost will teach you. No man has to teach you. When you have to be taught by another man, you're not walking in the grace of God. You're not leading. The leadership in your life is not that of the Holy Spirit. The teaching in your life is not that of the Holy Spirit. Tell somebody. They can talk to you. They can wear 30 suits around you, and you won't see it until 30 days later. Tell somebody. Because that's the dealing, as the Bible calls it, great derision. You think because you go to church, because you a preacher, you a deacon, and this day, you a member, that God will have you in great derision? If you none are here, that's exactly y'all don't want to talk to me. Exactly where you at. Tell somebody. And the damnation is coming down the pipe, is coming toward you. Hello, somebody, amen. Ain't nothing but the righteous gonna see God. Hello, somebody, amen. You ain't gonna spell in the fifth with God. You ain't gonna walk cockeyed with God. You ain't gonna have a worldly mind with God. And talk about praying the Lord, glory God, and blessing me. The devil is a lie. Huh? Because when God bless you, it don't make no difference whether it's up, down, right, and right. Jesus Christ always the same. You always up. You ain't got no bad week. You ain't got no bad month. You ain't got no bad paycheck. You ain't got no bad. God meets all of our needs according to God. You ain't got to get on your knees and beg God for nothing. You ain't got to look around, because God meets you before you even get there. God has a prayer before you even call on his name. You know, somebody, if you going through that, you going through it because you drag it on God, because you double-minded with God, because you got a world mind trying to live in a spirit house. Tell somebody. I thank the Lord, amen. The house of God was created for the son, not for the servant. God give us things that the prophets and righteous men desired to see but could not see. Hear but could not hear. These things are kept for his children. Yes. Hello, somebody, amen. They don't have access. They don't have the door you have. They can go in and follow you if you bid them to come in. When we go to the resort, if I show my membership card, I can go in and tell them you with me. Other than that, you can't come in. Hello, somebody. That's your point. That's right here on the world. Hello, somebody. Amen. So in what you call the Bible says in Proverbs 10 and 23 probably. It said, the blessing of the Lord it make him rich. And add no sorrows with it. Hello, somebody, amen. And look here. And because some of us have a few jobs, have a little money, we swear to God we rich. The devil of the lie. This word here is the, look here, in the book of Revelation, one more time. one more time in the book of Revelation, Revelation 2 and 7. Hello, somebody. Don't get it all mixed up, because we think we got a few dollars that we can say amen, praise the Lord. In the eyesight of God, that's an abomination. God did a bad for you to live all on the face of the earth. But look at what he said. He said, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the church. To him that overcome will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. It is in the spirit realm and not in the carnal realm. And when the Bible says that the blessing of God make a rich and added no sorrow with it, the first order of rich, when God make you rich, he gives you his spirit inwardly. You have foresight. You can see things. You don't need nobody to teach you nothing. You can walk with other men of God, whether you're a member, whether you're a deacon, whether you're a preacher, and not have to communicate every step to you, because the Holy Ghost, the Bible said, they shall not go from house to house saying, know ye the Lord, because all shall know the Lord. But not that when he said, know ye the Lord, that means that you can see any and everything and don't need nobody to teach you anything. It doesn't mean you're walking in pride. It means that you have become a fellow yoke fella to help get the work done and stop being a hindrance. Hello, somebody. So your form of riches, when you start talking about riches, see, you ain't got nothing and you got the tab because you dead in a week. When you rich in God, you, whatever you ask in dealing there, it's already there. You don't even have to ask it any longer. It's already there. Hello, somebody. God meets you in the checking there before you get there. Hello, somebody. See, you can win the whole world, lose your own soul. When God told the disciples, he said, all that rejoicing y'all doing about casting out demons, whatever, the rejoicing is that your name is written in the Lamb book of life. Because if it ain't written there, if you don't lose your life for my sake, and it don't mean how many houses you go to help people, it don't mean this and that, it means when you open your heart up to the Lord and receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and they can tell that God is leading you because you have an insight that's a gift that lets everybody, and I ain't talking about what I heard nobody else say. I'm talking about what the Holy Ghost himself gave me. Hello, somebody. Amen. See, some people get the Holy Ghost by the laying on a hand. Some of them that God is dropping on. Some of them get out on their knees and call. It's whatever the man of God tell you to do. It's by your obedience. You get all these things through obedience. Abraham was obedient to the word of God. Hello, somebody. You got it. They tell you to call on the Lord, and you without hindrance call on the Lord just because they said call on the Lord. See, Jesus said it like this here. If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asked you for a drink of water. In other words, the drink of water is help him and play with me. A call on the name of Jesus. I ain't gonna get to you. Call, you call for me. Okay. Yeah, you keep that water because I don't want it. But see how long you be on this seesaw ride. See how long you be on this wave of up, God, got some, ain't got nothing, up, God, don't make it, ain't like, up, God, praying for the same bill. I've been praying, but God is passing me, believe what I made it through. I prayed the other day. You spend a lot of time praying about material things. You spend a lot of time praying about material things. Huh? It's because you don't have the spiritual things in place. See, you can build a house on sand. Or you can build a house on the word of God. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Amen. This kingdom you looking at, it ain't what's there now. There been many kingdoms. There been the Babylonian kingdom, the Phoenicians, The Egyptian, the stone that the builder rejected, had become the head. Cause if you don't believe me, you watch it in the last day. You what, huh? You think everybody got the Spirit of God? You watch how you get the pain in his eyes and different color hair, and grandmama got red hair and the earring popping out of eyes and all kind of mess and huh, that warrior, huh? And they looking at you like, Hello somebody. How did I walk in the street with no clothes on? I said, man, y'all done went back to the jungle or something, man. Huh? Hello somebody, amen. But when you, hello somebody, when you open the door, see God placed before me an open door. But do you know how to go through the open door that God opened before you? Huh? Do you know what the first step is to going through the door that God placed before you? Huh? Hello somebody, let me help you out. When God placed before you an open door, he's opened his heart to you, open yours to him. So he want to come in and shop with you and you with him. But he can't come in and shop with you, you come in and shop with him. But he can't come in and shop with you because your heart is closed. I ain't trying to hear that you say. I'm my own man. I do things the way I do it. Man, Isaiah 55:8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways. You got a worldly mind, I got a heavenly mind, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Listen to this. If you don't never hear, if you always talk, I ain't trying to hear that man, he ain't tired of always talking. I talk like I talk, don't care whether you hear or not. Rich people talk in the kind of way they want, I already got. You know somebody, huh? Now you go get it somewhere else, I hope it's the right thing. Hello somebody, can I say it like this here? For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not hither, but waters the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater, so shall my word be, y'all ain't gonna like this here. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It will not return to be void. Oh, now, can I say the scary part? Somebody say, say the scary part. But it shall accomplish that which I please. Somebody say, what that mean? That mean, keep on hard your heart, because the word was for you no way. Right. It ain't going to come. God is sitting in this thing. He know who heals in here. He know who ain't going to hear. He know who ain't wasn't supposed to hear. He know why he spoke in parable. Shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing thereof I send it to. In other words, you could be sitting right there, ain't trying to hear it, got to tell you 30, 40 times. Guess what? He didn't send it to you. He sent it all around you. What'd you say? Preacher, you just fabricated. All right, I'm glad you said that. Huh? Back to the text, Matthew 13. Matthew 13. Look at what he said. Huh? and verse 10. And the disciples came unto him and said, why speakest thou unto them in parables? He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mystery of the kingdom of heaven. But to them it is not given. Huh? So when they brought the pride, he tell me what to do. But you ain't gonna hear, I know you ain't gonna hear why you did. He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God. That's why everybody can't say God moved in mysterious ways. If you turn to God, know all the ways of God. These things are given unto us to know. It's not given unto you. It might be the spirits in your eyesight. But we deserve the things of God. Tell us somebody. But of them it is not given. Read it itself. For whosoever has, to him shall be given. And he shall have more abundantly. But the whosoever has not, from him shall be taken away even that he has. Amen. God will use your resources and everything else. Whatever you have, whatever he blessed you with, he'll take it to facilitate what he's doing. You understand what I'm saying? He'll take it to facilitate what he's doing. Tell us about when you harden your heart or harden your neck or get so lifted up. My mama used to tell me a little thing. She said, son, respect is due a dog. You understand what I'm saying? With the same respect, when I was a contract out there, with the same respect I respected them people with, I respected all my brothers and sisters around. Amen? Huh? How many of y'all that I normally walk up to, and I know I talk to guys with a lot of them, but when I'm talking to you, I say yes, ma'am, or no, sir. When I say yes, sir, huh? Hello, somebody. So I give respect to any and everybody. You understand what I'm saying? That's just what it is. You are somebody. Yes, sir. Yeah, what do you want? Are you somebody too? When God blessed me with a little business, when I went out there and made money, when I pulled up on the corner, somebody having no work, everybody running. They said, boy, Doc pays a joker, huh? Man, he put some money in the joker head, amen? He don't have cut nobody, amen? And they were ran to do a good job. They were ran to be in the number, amen? Hello, somebody. I wasn't trying to hello somebody because God is more blessed to give than receive. God is blessing me. See, God is watching how I pay you because if I don't pay you right, I got a master in him. Y'all don't want to talk to me that ain't going to pay me right. If I don't know how to talk to you, the master in heaven ain't going to know how to talk to me. I'm like, man, y'all ain't got the job done yet. Man, I give me somebody else. And the next thing you know, God will be sitting up in heaven. I'm going to get me somebody else. Whatever you sow, that's why Jesus told us to bless and curse not. Because if you sow, if you blessing and cursing, blessing and curse, hello somebody. So what if faith one do not come out of the same father? God is not an Indian giver. Hello somebody, he cursed the ground for Adam's sake. And if you, y'all don't want to talk to me, now let me give you this understanding and get up out of here. God cursed the ground for Adam's sake. When Moses saw the burning breast, God told Moses to pull off your shoes, but this is holy ground. He make his ministers a flame and fire. It's a holy ground where they at. It's a foot washing where they at. It cleans you up. Hello, somebody. But once they, you know what? The Bible says he that reward evil for good. If a man of God wash your feet and you turn around and give him a dirty glass of water, what you say? Huh? When God bless you with an automobile out there, let it tell our God how. Huh? God bless us with a nice look, with a Lincoln, and I didn't want God, I thought it was a pimp, so I didn't want that right now. Hello, somebody. Amen. Huh? That car knew the way to the prison, to the jail, and everything else. And that car never cost us no money. And when we got rid of it, when Martha wrecked it, well, somebody ran into her, they gave us money for the car. I kept the car, called the junkyard, wanted to fix it. It should have been a couple $1,000. The man made a mistake and told me $75 for the part. When I got there, he said, ain't nowhere in the world, but because I told you $75, he said, I'm gonna give you the part. We fixed that car, we took it and traded in. They gave us a Caravan and gave us several hundred dollars on that car to trade that car in, amen. And everybody knew us, well, we were the dope dealers because of how God was blessing, amen. Tell somebody, amen. So God had a blessing, no sir. When you walk in there obedient, when the man of God tell you to get a van and not a truck, and if you go and get a van, God will bless you with all the truck. But the minute the Bible said, when you start being blessed with houses and stuff, you better watch that you don't pull back up off of God and stop being God, because you will inherit a curse. The blessing will turn into a curse. He said, I place before you a blessing and a curse, life and death. He said, Jesus said, I am the door. In other words, wherever the Spirit of the Lord is, that is liberty. Tell somebody, he become the door and the avenue for you go for your going and your coming. And as long as you take care of your door, tell somebody, amen. How many people want to know, everybody want to know their business? Get some oil and oil the door. Tell somebody, amen. Be a blessing to the door. The woman saw the man of God coming through town. She saw he was a holy man. Jesus said, if you don't believe me, believe me for the work's sake. She saw he was a holy man. She told her husband, she said, this is a man, I know I'm going to bring a man in your house, but we ought to get a bed, a table, and everything for this man of God. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. And he asked his servant, said, what is it that she needs? And she don't have a child. The Bible said he blessed her with a child. And when the family came, when the child died, he put the child back alive. Hello, somebody. Amen. And when the family came, she was led to, just like the child Isaac was led to the land flourishing. And when she came back, the servant was there talking to the king, and they gave her everything. She didn't miss nothing. He blessed her going, he blessed her coming, he blessed everything around her, because she knew how to treat the gift of God. That's why Jesus told the woman at the well, he said, if you knew the gift of God, see, the blessing of God make a rich. This, the blessing is the gift. If you know the blessing of God, or the gift of God, and who it is that acts, you would have asked him to give you, because he's the doorway to everything that you need. Hello, somebody. Amen. And you say, well, I ask in the name of Jesus. Yes, you can. But it also, you better read careful, because he said, he that received who I said. Before you can ask anything of me, you have to receive who I said. Y'all don't want to talk to me? In other words, everything in God's house is needed order. I might be out of order in your life and how you do things. But see, we have, see, one thing my mama, she had a third grade education, but she told me she was a respect and do a dog. What did that teach me? Class. You gotta have some kind of class. You have to have some kind of, it's more than having a dollar. You can have a dollar and don't have no class. You don't have no decency about yourself. You don't respect yourself. By disrespecting others, you so disrespect, that's what you're going to reap. Nobody's going to respect you because you so disrespect. Tell us about it, amen. When you respect people, people will respect you. If you only respect people that are of other colors, if you only respect, so respect people that you can get something from, tell us about it. The Lord told me, he said, if you have a party, invite the lame, invite the man, respect my people. Tell us about it. There's no respect a person in the Holy Ghost. All Jews, Greeks, and everything is the same. Woman, man, everything is the same. Master, servant, everything is the same in Christ Jesus. In other words, when you in the Spirit of God, when the Spirit of God is leading your life, you have respect for everything and everybody because God created the heaven and earth. God created the devil for his purpose. You don't speak evil of dignity. Somebody said, go ahead on praise. Somebody said, go ahead on praise. Somebody said, go ahead on praise. Somebody say, healing. It's knocking at your door. Healing. It's knocking at your door. I don't care what. The flesh done told you. The spirit is telling you. It's healing. It's knocking at your door. You got access. Let God in. You done heard what the doctor said. Hear what God got to say. By his stripes am I healed. I am the Lord. Thy God that healeth thee. Go somebody. Go somebody. Amen. God is a healer. He's a healer. He's a healer. Go somebody. Amen. Man, I went to thank God for healing me. Boy, look at everything when it started happening. My eyes went to get dim and I said, the devil is alive. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, huh? God, see, I have better than you ever been in your life. Thank you, huh? Hello, somebody. Amen. Abraham standeth not with the Lord. Amen. I thank the Lord. I give God praise, glory, and honor. Amen. I thank God for what he's already done. Thank God for what he's doing right now. God has a blessing with your name on it. God, the Bible said, Jesus is the way, the life, and the truth. My mama used to say, oh, this is like the man, this is like his way, because you can have the ways of this world. Huh? And when you got too many ways like this world, you got to to the right. See, one thing about it, you got to look in the mirror sometimes and look at yourself. Hello, somebody. You can have too many worldly ways. It'll be too much worldliness about you. Tell somebody, if you understand everything worldly, but don't really get the concept of God, if you just read the Bible and I got something to go tell somebody, but take nothing inside of you change. Tell somebody, if the spirit of your mind ain't changed, tell somebody, amen. If you that much better than everybody else, it ain't God. You believe that it ain't God. Because the apostles or nobody else want anybody bowing down to them. Hello, somebody. We a fellow yoke fellows, amen. But you ain't finna be no fellow yoke fellow with me with no worldly behind mine, because I will rebuke you on every corner. Hello, somebody. And don't care whether you get back and call the devil the devil. See, Charles Rado got one time, he said, I call an ace an ace or a spade a spade. Huh? And I do know who I am. You might hit me. But I bind up that mess and nothing in your life ever grow again. Hello, somebody. Amen. Huh? I'll speak something over your behind and the Lord Jesus Christ himself has to come down here and take up off your behalf. Nobody else can. And he might not. Go. Hello, somebody. Amen. But I also speak a blessing over your behalf and the devil out of here can't do nothing about it. Hello, somebody. Amen. I'm talking about the power of God now. I'm talking about the power of God. Amen. See, and what you do is you walk circumcised in this world. You walk circumcised in your heart. Amen. You carry yourself like somebody. Amen. And you're like dealing with a lot of police out there. They tell you about, oh, open the door, do this, that, that. You know, black folks, we gotta come a long way, man. We gotta come a lot of time I be in places and the police be in there, they get ready to pay for something, I say, I got this. I pay for it. You know what I mean? You're sending them a message, man. Everybody know. The people, white men don't understand you. And if you always talking about you got me because I'm black, that's all they know about you. When something happened to them, don't nobody but the white people care of something. But the people that look out for them. They'll come save us out of a burning house and we'll say thank you. And that's why I don't like no cop. Huh? Hello, somebody. We own my business, and we don't have no free coffee there for them. Right, right. But we want to call them every time somebody come in there and hit us upside the head. Huh? See, you have to be the one to initiate this kind of love. You know, love destroys evil. You got some dirty jokers in this world, and ain't nothing but the Lord gonna change. Hello, somebody. But you are a person that has to have class and character about yourself, and if you hold it, you need to be holding. Hello, somebody. If I gotta pick up that child out, that child gonna know I gotta pick him up. I ain't gonna go around the whole world and at the last minute hit that child up. It's where I do, don't do that. Because even a child is known by doing it. I know you. I ain't just met you. Hello, somebody. Amen. When people got nasty ways, I know them. Hello, somebody. And when people got good, decent ways, I know them. Hello, somebody. And out here, ain't nothing you got to make me kiss up to you and pretend you all of that. You understand that I am blessed? And if I ain't got you no good, you go on your way and I go mine. And I guarantee you the well don't run dry right here. Hello somebody. Amen. I thank the Lord. Amen. You drank the water out of my well. Hello, somebody, if you just put it the right way, amen. I thank the Lord. The pride and arrogance ain't got me. I'm drinking water out of his well. And I ain't lifting up about it. Hello, somebody, amen. If that's the spot he gave me, wherever you want me to sit at the table, that's where I'm sitting. Understand, sir. Wherever you want me to sit.